Thank you. I haven't asked my question yet. I'm going to ask mine, then I'll go right to Senator Hickenlooper. My question is going to be to all of you very, very quickly, if you can give us answers. Inflation. What's inflation in your your territories? What is the inflation? What is the most contributing factor to inflation? What are you fighting the most right now? Is it food? Is it energy prices? What is it, you know? But where's your inflation rate? What's your greatest challenge you have? We'll start with our friend from Puerto Rico.
Yes. Well, my concern with inflation is the cost.
What's your rate? What's your rate?
Is the, well, last year was about 6%, lower than the mainland, but still too high.
Sure.
And it impacted all the different areas you mentioned. But one area in particular that troubles me is cost of construction materials, because the way we're getting the funding from FEMA, it is basically through Section 428 of the Stafford Act, which caps the funding. Once you agree to an estimate with FEMA, and that happened in 2019, you have to live with it.
Gotcha.
Whatever cost, the cost overrun goes on you. So we're engaged in conversations with FEMA, and I'm alerting congressional leadership that FEMA should have the flexibility to adjust the cost, the cap on the projects, so that the scope of work of the projects doesn't get affected. Yeah. So that's the area of
most concern.
Your inflation
is about the same as ours, but basically your construction trying to get rebuilt back from your hurricanes and all that is
exactly.
Basically not able to proceed as you thought because you have cost overruns.
Yeah, well, we could end up not doing all the projects
that we
planned to do because of the cost of inflation.
Got it.
The inflation.
Congressman, or Governor, if you will.
Thank you. We're in the same situation.
Is your rate about 6?
Pardon me?
You're in a 6% rate, inflation rate?
No, we're higher.
Where are you?
We're much higher. I don't have the specific numbers.
You're higher than the national.
But it's very, very high.
Okay.
For consumer.
And what's the greatest cause of your inflation?
Pardon me?
What's causing you the greatest harm and basically making it difficult for your citizens?
I think transportation,
transportation.
Where we're at, and that's and energy, of course.
Just high cost of getting everything to the island,
absolutely.
Right? Okay.
Senator American Thompson. Samoa is at the 11%.
You're 11%?
Yes, sir. Costs, again, constructions, shipping into the island, and food are the high most rate of the inflation rates.
Congress?
I would say the same. Ours is about maybe 8 to 10%.
Okay.
And for example, Senator, price of eggs was $2.99, and now it's like $10. So
damn,
gas,
so you
energy.
Can't trust those chickens.
Gas. We're actually giving subsidies to our egg farmers to.
Well, the problem is the virus that hit the chickens, I mean, it's taking a toll everywhere in America, too.
So the cost of our inflation is, of course, energy, the gas prices.
Sure.
And also supply chain.
I'm going to get to energy real quick.
Yeah. Energy, 63 cents a kilowatt hour compared to like 12 here. Food, pack of chicken thighs is $35.
What's your inflation, Governor? Your inflation rate?
In the last 3 years, 5%, 5%, 7% growth. And then construction, a public housing unit is costing us $380,000 to $500,000 per unit. And construction has tripled in cost. Inflation and the hurricane recovery, but it's really bad.
I do know the territories and the islands are basically that energy is a tremendous factor for you all, the reliability and also the cost. Now with the Inflation Reduction Act and also the Bipartisan Infrastructure Bill, do you see much interest and much technology are coming your way, or people wanting to develop hydrogen, different types of new fuel, reliable fuel, you know, even cleaner fuel, or using fossil in a much cleaner way? Are you seeing those interests peaking in your areas? Because you would be natural for that, being more self-reliant.
So for us, solar energy, of course.
Sure.
And we have a goal of 100% alternative energy by 2045. But we're also looking at virtual power plants using solar energy coming from rooftops. That's something that...
Storage is the biggest concern you have right now because you don't have the reliability on storage.
Right.
And we're trying to develop the storage as quickly as possible. Hydrogen is a tremendous replacement for what we've been doing. And if you have that much... You know, you can do green hydrogen, you can do green ammonia. There's so much. I want to make sure that you all have all the opportunities that we have developed and we're trying to mature it very quickly. So let us know how we can help on energy, on that. You know, I know oil, most of you ran by oil for a long time, and I know it, on the island, as far as in your situation with the refinery, we need that refinery up and running. We do it for stability for the whole region, and I agree with you.
I should just say that I issued an executive order in Puerto Rico making green hydrogen renewable energy, considering it as renewable energy, because we have a renewable energy portfolio which we have to standard, which we have to meet. And
if you're getting pushback, they're saying green hydrogen does not fit as renewable?
The term is being used, but what I mean is the following. Hydrogen, I agree with you.
It's got horsepower.
That's the future.
It's got horsepower, and you have stability.
That's the future. But I am, since I have this standard that I have to meet as a matter of our energy public policy law, I'm considering hydrogen.
I would hope you would.
As one of the renewable energy sources.
And we can make blue hydrogen also, and if we capture it and basically and sequester the CO2 from that,
exactly,
that would raise that to a level. And then we have a $3 credit on it. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to jump over to, because I know that we have to run. The bell's been rung. Thank you all. We're going to have a lot of more discussion on this. We want to help you and make sure you have access to every opportunity of this new transition that's going on, using all of the above in a cleaner fashion than we've ever had before. Senator Hickenlooper.